Hi, everybody. Today we're going to be doing our video, Web Analytics TV. We're now calling it A Dash of Analytics with Nick and Nash.
That's a user-generated suggestion.
That's a great one. It's a great one.
So keep your ideas coming. We want a new one every time.
Definitely. So let's start off right here with the first question for you, Avinash. And this one is from Pakistan.
Wow. Hello, Pakistan.
A spammer used a script to autoload and fill my Contact Us page. This not only caused a spam emails, but thousands of visitors and page views in GA. This happened for 2 days. My GA data messed up due to this. Can I delete the record for these days?
Yeah, so it is not possible for you to delete data for those page views in Google Analytics. But what you can do, a better idea, is to just create an advanced segment that would filter out this data, so you'll be able to simply see the data that is more accurate. So just use the advanced segmentation feature to report the data there. And the nice thing is that it was only 2 days, and those 2 days will be passed pretty quickly, so
right.
It wouldn't be that big of an impact. But please leverage advanced segmentation.
Great answer.
So the next one is on e-commerce, Nick, and it's for you. It's from Tamin, Oregon. Hi, Tamin.
Hey.
Tracking e-commerce transactions while using a third-party shopping cart is proving to be quite difficult. Can you explain how to find variables needed for the thank you page code in order to track these transactions? So this is basically fulfillment happening
right
away from the website.
Right. So at the end of the day, Google Analytics tracks transactions, and you have to send a certain pieces of data. To do that, you have to modify and have access to modify the final receipt page.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the pages make it really hard to do it, and the way to actually access the values if they're embedded on these pages is using JavaScript. There's something called a document object model, and you can use JavaScript to access different elements and in the values, which will actually be the values in the receipt page. So use JavaScript, get the values, put it in analytics so you can send it.
Yeah.
And I guess the other thing to mention is that we also have GAC partners who are
exactly
really good at doing this type of stuff, and if you want to go to our partner page, they can help you out.
For these complicated things, it makes sense because there's a lot of different things to do.
Right.
So it helps to make use of a GAC. Just go to bit.ly/GAC, and you'll find the link.
Yep.
Another one for you, Nick.
Okay.
And also related to cross-domain tracking. We have a shopping cart that goes off-site. Our developer has inserted the GA code. Oh, so good. So this time they've done something. What's missing in GA is the GA data on keywords, referrers. Basically, is it possible to basically take the data from the third-party tracking site and the site for our own data and merge it so they can do proper analysis?
Right. This is a common place where a lot of issues happen. And the reason why it happens is when somebody comes to your site, we give you a campaign, and that's stored in a cookie. The cookie can only be read by the domain of the website that sets it. And so because this shopping cart is on another domain, what's most likely happening is that cookie information is not getting propagated to that final website. So we actually have some links on how to do cross-domain linking that will alleviate this problem and allow you to see that to make it accurate.
So Pauline from Surrey, British Columbia, please go make sure that you go back to the blog post and look at the link that we're going to add just for you. Give that to your developer and, you know, angels will sing.
Great. So a question for you here, Avinash. In the referring site section, it lists two websites that have referred traffic to my site, yet I'm unable to find any of the links on their sites. I also believe it's highly unlikely that they refer traffic to me since they are competitors. Thoughts?
So typically what this if you see it in the referring site section, it means that at some point now or in the past, there was a link that actually was to your website. And typically what we see happen in this case is, first thing you should do is actually drill down from the domain, referring domain, to the actual individual pages. Just click on the domain, it'll show you in Google Analytics all the pages. Go back and look at the pages. And what we've noticed this is a lot of times is that when people add comments or reviews on the pages, and they could be your competitors, and they actually add a link that comes back to your website. Or it is also sometimes possible that in the past, we would kind of do QA and testing on the internal site pages that were not available to the customer.
Right.
We would add all kinds of links, and of course, people would click through, and that would send the referrer out. So in some shape, way, or form, the referrer is coming from that particular website, and if you don't see a link at the moment on it, perhaps it was there in the past. But just if you review your data more frequently, you'll be able to see that. So go back and dig and drill down a little bit more.
Yep. Great answer. So here's another question for you, Avinash. This is from Dave Stone in Brighton, UK. In visitors map overlay, where's Singapore? Either I'm going crazy or you're missing a country. So, you know, where is Singapore?
I know, Singapore exists. For all of you who are worried about it, it does exist. Beautiful country, I love going to Singapore. If you can't find it, Singapore is a very small country, it's kind of subsumed by Malaysia. But what you'll do is, rather than look at the map overlay, just drill down. At the bottom, there's a table, and in the table, just search for Singapore. That's it. I mean, it's very simple. And you'll see a row of data show up just for Singapore, and it'll highlight in the map. It'll probably be such a small dot that you might not be able to see it in the map view. Also, if you want to switch over from the country maximum view down to the region and city views, you'll start to see more granularity in the map overlay. So those are two ways in which you can go discover Singapore. We assure you that it does exist.
It does exist, yeah.
Here's one for you, Nick, from No Zero from New Jersey. Hi, No Zero.
Hey.
In the campaign's report, how can I see referring URLs? Referring URL like in referring sites report. So in campaigns report, it seems that we don't show you the referring URL. So how do we do that, Nick?
Right. I think all we show you in the campaigns report is what we call the source. Mm-hmm. And that's typically just the domain. So what you can do is, we have profile filters. And we talked about them in previous shows. But the profile filters allow you to manipulate the data that we collect before it gets processed. So that way you can say, give me the referral URI information, stuff it into the campaign data, GA will process it, and you'll be able to see it in your reports.
So basically what No Zero has to do is make sure that he goes and creates this filter in his Google Analytics admin settings.
Right.
And from then going forward, he'll be able to see it exactly as he does in the referring sites report.
Right. He can manipulate any of the values
I see. Okay, great. So we'll add a link to it.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll add a link to it.
Right. Here's a question for you, Avinash, from Newburgh, Oregon, from Peter C. Our site tends to have users who find us via online advertising convert later via branded search. So they're coming from one search and then they're coming back from a different type of search. This is easy in AdWords since it has separate tracking, but I'm afraid of missing conversions in other campaigns. Any suggestions on what we can do?
So, Peter, you're not missing any conversions in the sense that AdWords looks at it from a source perspective, and Google Analytics looks at it from, if you will, a target perspective, and a person could come from any different source multiple times. So what Google Analytics is doing is capturing all your conversions 100%, mm-hmm. so that you're not losing anything. It's just that what Google Analytics does by default is, if you come multiple times, you came on a banner ad, and then you came, let's say, on an AdWords ad, it will give the credit in Google Analytics, it will report it as an AdWords conversion. And it won't report it as a display conversion. Mm, right. Now, this could be paid and organic. I mean, literally anything except direct is treated as a campaign in Google Analytics. So in your case, if you have a choice in Google Analytics, would you like the first campaign to be showing up in the report for conversion, or would you like it to be the last one? And we'll add a link in this blog post that will tell you exactly how to do that. But you'll be able to actually set that as you wish and see the conversions from the first point of view or the last point of view. But I want to reiterate, all your conversions are in Google Analytics and they are being reported properly.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Good. So here from Poland, Krakow in Poland, all the way, very far away, Nick. In the keywords report, I have many keywords which have zero visits. I think this is a repeat offender. We got this one.
We got this one before.
Earlier, yeah, yes. Yeah. They have a medium equal organic. How is this possible? So what's your answer for Daniel?
Yeah, I know. It's a good question. So let's just go back and say visits are calculated. Visits are incremented when the browser closes or after 30 minutes of inactivity with the browser. So if somebody comes to the site for one campaign, leaves, and comes back within 30 minutes, well, actually, in GA, we'll report it as two clicks and as two different campaigns. But the second one has zero visits because the first one has the visit.
Sure.
So that way the visits are accurate, and you also get all the referring clicks that come back to the site. So that's why the second one has the zero visits.
Right. So basically, in scenarios where I might go to a website two or three times through Google search, all within the 1 minute,
right,
this kind of a scenario arises.
It happens, yeah.
Mercifully, there aren't a lot of people like me who will do that in 3 minutes. Good. So the next one's about content.
Yes. So this is a question about your book. This is from Rishi in Chicago. In your book, Web Analytics, An Hour a Day, you talked about page influence report and click tracks.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Is the dollar index column in Google Analytics' version of page influence?
Yeah, so click tracks, a wonderful tool. It actually computes influence in a in a much more sophisticated way, and it applies various filters. But at the end of the day, what it says is, leading up to a conversion point, how frequently do the pages show up across multiple sessions? So, a page, does it show up more times in a particular person's conversion or less times? Now, that's a very crude way of framing what ClickTracks does, but it does do much more sophisticated things. So it's not a one-to-one mapping between dollar index value and page influence in ClickTracks. What page influence is trying to do, or dollar page index is trying to do, is to actually say, if somebody converted or met a goal, and if you have a value assigned to the goal, the other pages in the session get sort of a distributed value to it. It's a slightly different way of thinking about it, but in some, both, the common thing between both of them is they're trying to give you a feel for how important a page is, but they come about in very different ways. I don't want to say that they are the same thing. So just dig a little bit deeper, depending on the tool that you're using, and make sure that you understand the methodology being used, because it is different.
Yep, great.
So here's another one in content for you, Nick, and this is from JR in Denver. And JR is asking, why is it that firing an event on the entrance page brings the bounce rate to 0%?
That's a good question. So yeah. First of all, it mentions that there's an entrance page, so there must be some page view tracking. A bounce is calculated as one page view per visit, or actually one page view or event per visit. So the fact that they're actually sending an event and then a page means that there's two of those within a visit, which means that's not a bounce. So because you're firing the event first, the bounce is zero, and that's why the rate is also zero.
Exactly. And then we can merge this with the next question from Chris Leon in Richmond, Virginia. Mm-hmm. And Chris asks, implementing event tracking has dropped the bounce rate from high 20s, low 30s. But Chris should be happy. That's right. Good answer. Chris, you should be happy. To less than 1%, while it hasn't had any impact on a third side, what circumstances cause this to happen? So it's exactly the same thing, Chris, that Nick just mentioned, which is what Google Analytics and Omniture and WebTrends and all the tools that compute bounce rate are trying to do is say, which of the sessions with just one hit?
Right. Or one interaction.
Exactly, like, yeah, one right. interaction in there. Yeah. And mostly for when we compute bounce rate, we're thinking of page views, and if there's just one interaction, a page view, and you go away, well, that's a bounce. In this case, the person did something to trigger another interaction to happen. So hit play on the video on your website, still on the same page. I hit reply in Gmail, still on the same page. But all of these activities, while they only trigger one page view for the person who came to your website, it triggered multiple interactions. And that second interaction takes the bounce rate down to zero, which is probably, I think, as it should be. Because what it's saying is, did somebody come to your website and do nothing and leave?
Right.
That's really what bounce rate is trying to get at. In this case, when an event gets fired off, something occurs, an interaction, and that's why the bounce rate goes down to zero. But it's good to know that when you use event tracking, you should keep sort of this at the back of your mind.
Yeah.
But as long as there is an interaction, the bounce rate zero is the expected behavior. Mm-hmm. Make sense?
Yeah, makes sense to me.
Great. We've got, I think we've got some feature requests.
Definitely.
Which is great. Let me cover them real quick. This one's all the way from Denmark. And Nellis from Denmark says, is it possible in future that Google Analytics catch data from Google Alerts app? As an example, with the new annotation added, it could be nice if it could insert the alerts automatically from search keyword you set up. So basically, I think in some sense, Nellis is asking for an expansion of what annotations does and behaves, for an annotation to be triggered perhaps automatically. And it's a great request, Nellis, and we'll pass it on to the team. David from Maidenhead in the UK asks, Opera Mini Browser makes up 45% of hits in my mobile site. Is there a plan to improve tracking support, country mobile device reports, etc.? So absolutely, David. I think in the last 6 months, we've done a lot of things to dramatically overhaul the data that you were getting from mobile tracking. And we continue to plan on upgrading the tool and keep on increasing the quality and the quantity of data that you get, because there are lots more data sources we can include. But we'll send this on to our mobile team that's working on GA. The next one, I'll let you take this one, Nick. And it says, my GA account, this is from Click This Denver, Colorado. My GA account contains multiple websites organized by region. Within these accounts, we have multiple profiles with GA add functionalities, so we can generate a report for multiple profiles instead of one at a time and move a profile. Thanks.
Right, so it sounds like roller reporting.
Complicated question.
Right. A lot of customization. And I mean, at this point, you know, we have our API. it's really easy to actually set all this up and customize it and do all these complex stuff that the product is still working on. And you definitely use our API and you can create these custom reports.
Exactly. I think that if you have needs that are complicated, you'll probably end up using custom reporting, advanced segmentation, custom variables, event tracking type things. Now that allows you to do more sophisticated thing in Google Analytics than you did a year ago. But now, really, I mean, the last 6 months, I've kind of given up doing complicated, really complicated custom things within GA. I just go to the API.
Right.
I mean, this is
so much easier
and so much wonderfulness to be able to just pull the data out, hack it, report it any which way I want. So definitely explore that. Nick, you'll add a link?
A link to the API.
To the API glory.
There you go.
Great. Another one for you, Nick. What is the process? I love this one. This one from Wolf Friend in Washington, D.C. Lots of wolves in Washington.
Yeah.
What is the process of reporting a website that violates Google Analytics terms of service? This is our good friend.
The wolves in Washington, D.C. just let us know. There's a contact us link at the bottom of the health center. Just go through there and just let us know what it is, and then we'll investigate and we'll take a look.
Exactly.
Yep.
And one more quick feature request. I love the new annotations. Thank you. I think it's a great feature. Does Google plan to use letter set annotations just for specific report that we're doing? Same with your campaign, I would add a note to be configurable, viewable when reading your campaign report. And today I believe that there is some level of customizations available in when you apply annotations to different reports. You can also star them, favorite them, and all kinds of things. So please explore the annotations feature a bit more. But we are thinking about what would it take to sort of take it to the next level and perhaps various with permissions and all kinds of things. We'll take this back to the annotations team and make sure that they have your feedback. This is from Nozira again in New Jersey. So thank you very much, Nozira. So with that, that's the last question we have for this quick, breezy episode of Web Analytics TV. Please make sure that you go to our moderator page and submit new questions or vote on questions by other users. Anything to do with Google Analytics, Web Analytics, really anything, or a new name for our show. We welcome that. So
every week.
Thanks so much.
Take care.